to make it easy for you, it is, we dismiss it because it's easier than what you think. With cables, if you remember, we did this, something in here, what we did in here. We isolated this point and we said, here is W, here is T in this cable, TA, and here is TC, correct? When we deal with cables, we started with this beam, cut from here, then cut from here. Every time the load changes, we make a cut. We have a cable, and this cable is carrying multiple forces, not only one. Okay? If you start isolating any one of them that you have maximum two unknowns, you are okay. If not, you started from one edge, from whatever is the cable starting. Let's say that the cable is carrying loads like this. Isolate all this area, and you will replace this with the V here. Here is connected whatever it is. Then, so this is first, you isolate this one. Then you go with this one, isolate this one, and so on. It's just the same principle of isolating members and replacing it with forces. Or just like isolate the node where they are connected and apply three forces with two equations with equilibrium. If not, go from one end to another. Keep isolating just like what you did with the structure, with the truss when we dealt with joints. Keep going from one to another. That's, we missed one class, that's why we are a little bit behind. So we will go to the following one, which it is the friction. The friction, in real life, there is not anything called frictionless surface that doesn't have a friction. Even these, when you roll them, there is a friction. They are rulers, they are smooth. On the table, look. Why stops? What makes stops? Just the friction. So what is going in here, that there is in real life, no matter what we do to smoothen things, there is still friction there. Okay? So, if you start pushing this book, start pushing this book, put a little force. It doesn't move. Why? There is a friction there. So what we say, every time we have a contact between two bodies, there is a contact, tangential forces are created there. And these tangential forces are the friction. Why are tangential forces? Because here is a body and here is another body. Tangential forces means in this direction. Here is tangential forces that we talk about are in this direction. Here is, I'm trying to, I have a wall in here and I have this body in here. And I'm trying to push a force right in here to pull it up. It has a friction in here. That's the friction, is the tangential force right in here. Okay? So all the time, whenever we have a contact between two bodies, two structures, and there is some force there, immediately there is some reaction there, some friction there. And the friction all the time is going on the same line of the base. Just like the simple support. You remember the simple support takes one force? This is takes one force tangential all the time with the body, no matter what is the surface is, it goes with it. So, if we start putting a force, just be friction. I start pushing the book with a force, increasing the amount, Here, quarter pound, half pound, three quarter. As long as this is increases, it looks like the friction force increases as well. So this is force increase, the friction increase. Till I get to the point here, it's called the maximum possible that this surface can handle. Then it's moving. As long as it starts moving, goes like this. Why? Your car, not your car, somebody's else car is stopped in the middle of the road. And you say, guys, come push me. When you start pushing, it's hard till the wheel rolls, correct? Then it's easier, agree? That's what we call it kinetic friction. The kinetic friction all the time is less than the static friction. So here, we are, till this point, we are in equilibrium, correct? And here we are in static, here we are in dynamics. We are start moving here. Here is kinetic. Here is static. Okay? So when B over zero, but is smaller than Fm, you are in equilibrium. And still nothing moving. When B equal the force of friction maximum, you are still in equilibrium, but we call it bending motion. You are ready to move. At that point, between moving and not moving, there is a thickness over here. Very, very little that we cannot measure. But after that, it's going to move. So we are bending motion here. And if P greater than Fm, you are in kinetic motion or in motion, and this is when it is, at this moment, when it is passes it, we drop, because we move to the kinetic, okay? The friction, the normal reaction times the mu, that is the general friction, how you would calculate the friction. What is the mu? The mu is constant, friction constant, or constant of friction, whatever you want to call it. What is this depends on what? Material. Depends on the material, depends on the surface. Okay? So if you open your book, you will find a table telling you the friction between wood and the glass, the friction between metal and I don't know what. At that time when I studied engineering at your level, we used to have books bigger than this one, hundreds and hundreds of books, of tables, telling you wood to wood. And when it comes to wood, tells you about how smooth is the surface. Wood is smooth with 0.1 paper sand, wood with rough wood 0.3 paper sand. What's the friction between them? Then wood with the glass, then wood with metal, then wood with aluminum, then wood with rubber, then wood with plastic, all kinds of materials, all kinds of surfaces, and how rough or smooth is this. Your table here is going to give you like four elements. Which page is that?
414.
414. Here, metal to metal. Metal to metal used to have two, three tables about metal to metal. Start with metal. Smooth at this level. I don't know what. Grades. They have grades of how smooth is material. then moved to metal to wood. And this is start like probabilities increasing because you need to have metal 0-1 with all kinds of wood, metal 0-2 all kinds of wood, metal 0-3 all kinds of wood, and so on. So there is lots of things how to find the mu. However, at this moment, you the mu will be giving, or the mu will be asked to asking you to find it. It's not that difficult either or. So what we do in here is if we have. Let's start with a simple example. This block is sitting in here on this surface. This surface here is m mu s equal 0.3, for example, any number. This is has a W. From this W, you have a normal reaction. Agree? Normal reaction. If I apply a force here at any direction, it doesn't matter, force P, what I should expect from the surface in here? Resistance from here of friction. Agree? Let's calculate something. Let's throw some numbers. P equal 100 newton. W equal 200 newton. Mu is 0.3. Let's see, is this force going to move this block from its location or not? And if it moves it, how we can improve the surface to keep it there, even with a 300 force wind, for example, not to move that box sitting out there? What I should do with the concrete or with the surface between them? Glue them, put some screws down, or put some rubber. So let's see. First of all, what is N? 200. Because sum of forces on Y equals 0. You have W is down, negative W, positive NR. From here, N equals 200. Agree? Where we wrote the equation? Here is the equation. Here, the friction force is going to be the 200 times
mu.
Mu. 0.3, which it is 60. So I have a resistance through this weight of 60 newton. I have a force here pushing of 100, so sum of forces on X equals 0. I have 100 in this, correct? That's positive. I have resistance of 60. Is that 0? Correct?
You're accelerating.
What does that mean? The force that pushing it, moving it to move. So if I want to make it stop there, what I should do? How to glue it? Improve the surface.
Yeah.
That's why City of Portland in the past 5 years has spent millions of dollars at the ramps on this intersection of the sidewalk to glue there a yellow pad. Did you notice the yellow pad around downtown Portland?
Yeah.
This is to improve the surface. This is to change the mu. Because there was concrete there, and no matter what you do to the concrete, even if you dig in it a little bit to make it rough, we walk on it, we smoothen it. So they don't want that. They bought this rubber and they put it there. So in this case, I have to improve the mu. Make sense to you? So if I look at it in order to have a force of 100, I get an equilibrium, correct? Force of 100, I get an equilibrium. And we set the F equal M times the mu, or mu equal F over L. Correct? If I have F of 100 and N of 200, then I need 0.5 friction. Make sense?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, we just covered the main ideas of the chapter, and we will do some questions next Wednesday. So by this Wednesday, we are done with the chapter. Next week, we do the last chapter Monday and Wednesday.